What's up, everybody? This is Simon of the Tom and Stromberg channel. And I'm here at the beautiful Swiss Life Hall to have a little chat and a conversation with Mr. Mike Mangini of Dream Theater.
Woo!
Hello. Hello, Mike. How are you doing?
Great.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to
see you again.
Yes, again. Absolutely. Yeah.
So I want to talk about your very nice looking big
setup
especially
of drums. Your voice is echoing right down
the tube. Oh, is it? Yeah.
I can hear you right here.
Hello, Mike. How are you doing?
Oh, yeah, we'll put the hamsters in there later.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
All right. So why is it such a big set? And why did you like put all the cymbals so high? And you have that specific setup of your drums.
What do you mean by big? I have less drums than most.
You do?
Yeah, because...
Okay.
Well, think about it. There's a drummer with two floor toms and three racks.
Yeah, right.
How many drums is that? Five, right?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five.
Okay.
Six-piece kit. It's not that much.
No,
it just
not.
Looks weird, and it has my whole career. It's confused people, and oh my gosh, look at that. And then it's always less drums, especially drum clinics. It's less than others.
Right.
This makes it add up, but I had to add these to sound like the old Dream Theater.
Ah, this songs. Is the reason why you put
just
them up,
yeah. How am I supposed to sound like the record if I don't have the equipment, right?
Yeah, that's true.
I couldn't. I mean, if I was going to do that, I could use a 5-6, very, very small kit and just play my way, but I can't get away with that in this band. You can't win either way. If I play the parts exactly, I'm a creep. If I don't play it, oh my gosh, I must not be able to play. It's just, these people are just crazy. So anyway, I'm just going to do what I need to do, but for me, I need to sound like the album.
Yeah.
And so I added those, and it's, okay, so here it is, yeah.
Right. And this is like a complete mirror of each side, so do you have the same symbols?
Yeah, the reason, it's a musical reason. When I set this up, I was not able to play it years ago, and the reason I have it as a mirror image is so my hands won't cross. And the reason I don't want my hands to cross is I like to keep a ride source designating the time while my other limbs play... orchestrally,
I understand,
musical.
Yeah.
And I can't do that. If
you go, words, I guess, yeah.
Traditional drumming means you play a beat, you do a drum fill. You go back and you play a beat, and then you do a drum fill.
That's right, yeah.
I don't want to play like that. I know I want to be able to play both, keep the time and orchestrate, so I had to do this.
All right.
And the cymbals are actually closer to me up high like this. They're not further away like everyone thinks. It's just, nobody knows what they're talking about.
Because I was wondering.
Until they sit here.
Yeah.
But look, I mean, if I took a stick and the cymbals were out more, my arm would be extended. Look at this. I'm bent like this.
Oh,
this
yeah.
is like really comfortable.
It seems so. Because I was wondering if
I
have like any problems, because in some videos it looks like you have to stretch out a little bit more.
You know what? When we play a show, I do it on purpose just to... kind of a wise guy.
Yeah.
Like I'll put my hands way up and go, oh, during the show. I'll hold my arm and I'll put it as high as I can and I hit like this just because I know it's driving people crazy. It's fun. So it's actually closer, but it's more for sound, more isolation, more control by the guys to, you know, because I never hear my cymbals enough. So now this gives them a chance to at least turn them up without having the leakage from the snare drum.
Yeah, I understand. Like a bleed kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Wow, that's pretty interesting. Mm-hmm. So, and the tuning of the drums, is this like, because I think you have like an orchestral kind of background from your childhood?
Yes, but the drum is the drum.
Yeah.
Do you know, in other words, I'm not going to try to force this drum to be a D if it's more of a D flat.
Yeah,
plus,
I understand.
I've run into trouble. Like, I ran into trouble when I used the roto toms because for some reason, and I don't know why, like, the music that I write, the riffs are in D usually or some funky keys, but my drums always end up in, like, D.
Okay.
It's something with D, and, like, every other one. So it would be D, 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 or D, 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 depending on the drum head. But I don't want to force it because I've run into trouble where I've had the roto toms be so clear with the pitch that they interfered with like the key of E on guitar. Mm-hmm. And it just, I'll never forget a session I did in Florida, the songwriter was like, he's like, I've never experienced this. Your drums are like a half a step or a step out of tune with my guitar. I'm like, what? I never knew. So I don't want to force the drums someplace that they don't want to go. Wherever this drum settles, it changes too. The more the head breaks in, then Eric will adjust the tuning.
Yeah.
It sits where it sits. So I'm not that into it.
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. Yeah, cool. Thanks. Another thing I wanted to talk about is what I'm always like interested in is because everyone is different and special.
Yes.
What you have on your in-ear.
I have a fairly equal mix, but most of it is click because I have a job to do.
Yeah.
You know, all of this stuff is tied into me. Our production is so razor sharp. I can't go off by milliseconds or, well, I mean, I don't think anyone's really gonna notice, but we notice.
Yeah,
so like I'm dead on this and it's a job that I have to do. In other words, it's more than just playing the songs in this band. We have changed. The band has changed what it does, how it does it, and what it actually is these days. And so we're tied in so we can utilize such, you know, cool stuff for our show, for the fans and everything, and also for consistency. Mm-hmm. So if I'm dialed in like that, the guitar delays are in time. The effects are in time.
I understand.
The samples are in time. Yeah. Everybody's relaxed. The crew dials it in. So they rely on me. So I have that job. But it's equal with the musicians, and I pan it how I see it. I don't like a wide panning on my drums because then the drums start to fire off too far right and left. Mm-hmm. But I have Jordan more to the right, because there
he's
he is.
Standing right, yeah.
I have John Petrucci more to the left, and James is in the middle, and John Myung is in the middle.
All right.
And my drums are up a little bit above. Again, I have a job to do, so
yeah.
I want to hear where everyone is, but they're playing to me, so.
Yeah. And do you like take care of the click, or is that from a system out at the front of house, or how do you start and stop?
It's all tied in with the sync, the video sync.
Okay.
So it's worked on for months by myself, Jimmy T, anyone else that now understands that the burden is more work for me than learning the songs.
Yeah.
Because I have to know the songs, kind of, and I don't. I've never, you know, played some of these songs, and I got to make it all just right, you know. And then we have the video made, so it's just an entire process. But I have to hear to do my job,
yeah, okay.
Which is different. Like G3, mm-hmm. I play with G3.
It's a band of Jordan.
John Petrucci.
Right?
Yeah. I just had an iPad with a metronome.
Oh yeah, and
you know, we don't have to have it. I mean, I've played the Dream Theater songs with no metronome, no nothing, and G3 with, you know, whatever. My timing's, you know, very consistent, but it's not perfect, right? So this way, though, again, the other musicians become comfortable with the delays being in time, with the whatever the samples are. Everything else is in time now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I totally understand.
And once you go that way, it's like I've never been in a band where they go backwards. It's like you can't, it's like a... How do I explain? I don't know. I don't want to go backwards.
Yeah.
But I manually operated the click. Mm-hmm. You know, for sections that accelerando or decelerando, I turn it off. I did it with Steve.
So you have the chance to control.
Yeah, but I play it. I actually play the click track
on
the iPad. I did this with Steve Vai.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where we would play a song and Steve would comment. It's like, that's too consistent. It's too perfect. It wasn't written that way. It was written with this. Like, yeah, absolutely. Let's play musical. So I turn it off.
Yeah.
That's like not that big of a deal. So
yeah. Cool. Oh, it's very interesting because you, as a usual drummer, or you don't get a lot of in-depth view in these kind of big productions.
Yeah, and so, how it works. And so,
yeah, right.
And I will say, and you didn't ask me, but I do want to add it about this equipment that I'm playing. I mean, I might not look it. I'm really hitting this stuff hard. You know,
that was actually a question. If you
it really has been hit hard, and these guys, the crew, you know, they put it together and they get it out of here and then it flies on planes. The stuff can get destroyed. So everything you see here from Shure redesigning this to Pearl, you know, making the mm-hmm. icon rack like that, to Remo even reinforcing the drum heads with the new Mylar. And of course, I'm talking about the products, but these things don't break.
Oh, they don't.
I don't break cymbals much. It has to be in an ice arena. So the bottom line is I come up here for a show. I can end this by telling you something crazy, which is right now I'm sitting on the drums. I don't do this before shows at all. We don't do sound check.
Oh, you don't do sound check?
No, I go straight to the stage. And, you know, Eric has this stuff perfect every night. it's me that's different. Like, I might be in a different mood, or like, oh, am I sitting too high or sitting too low? Oh my gosh, and I might change the stool and go, oh no, why did I do that? You know? But the drums are exactly in the same place, and they're solid. Again, everything from the cymbals to the microphones to the, you name it, the pedals, it just, everything is strong and reinforced, because I can't break anything. You know, the sticks, I mean, I don't want to forget that. These wicked pistons are made thicker at the top. So when I hold my hand, my fulcrum down here, the stick is way heavier because the weight throws it. But when I have to go fast, like really fast, I put my fulcrum up here and then I can, and again, the cymbals are not, look, I'm not like this and,
you're just really relaxed.
They're up out of the way, but they're also close in.
And you still can do your fast
right
hand.
Yeah, I can play underneath and be a silly guy. You know what? I have never done anything that has freaked so many people out or even aggravated someone. I'm like, why are you upset that my cymbals are out? I think, and I hope that people eventually understand I have a pretty big sense of humor.
I think they get it.
Yeah, I mean, stuff I do is just to be funny. You know, I'll play with the one hand and underneath and do the whole fill and hold. And I'm just having a good time, or I'll switch to lefty just to keep myself occupied and busy and engaged.
Yeah, right.
So these are some of the things that are not normal, but this gear is the best. Thank you, Pearl. Thank you, Zildjian. Thank you, Remo. Thank you, Shure. Thank you, Vader. Thank you. Who else? Oh, Roland. They got all kinds of Roland things. Anyway, you know, that's a whole other story.
Yeah. So, and when it comes to, we got to end
because I have to.
Oh, we have to. I
don't have much time.
Yeah, okay. Right.
But, sorry.
Okay. So, thank you so much.
Okay, Mike. You're welcome.
Yeah, it was very nice to talk to you.
Excellent.
And thank you for all the information. It was really interesting.
Yeah, cool.
I hope you have a great show tonight.
Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of, you're going to London, right?
Yes, we are. We have to film a DVD, so that should be a lot of fun. We'll get some cameras on the feet, and maybe on my nose, over here, coming down, on these way up high cymbals.
Yay.
All right, I think I have what I need here. Have a good one.
Yeah, thanks.
What's the name of the channel?
It's Tommen's Drum Bash.
Tommen's Drum Bash?
Yeah.
That's a great name. Tommen's Drum Bash. Good on you.
So this was Mike Mangini, incredible guy, super funny, incredible player. You have to listen to the new Distance Over Time album of Dream Theater. It's really great. It has some really awesome drum parts. Thank you so much for watching. There are also other videos of Jordan Rudess, John Myung, and John Petrucci. You should totally check them out if you're interested in guitars, bass, and keys. Thank you so much for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hit subscribe. Make sure you ring the bell. And I see you in another video. Simon out. Bye-bye.